Hi there, your computer friend Connie here. Let's talk about how to get more columns in Microsoft Teams. So I'm in the files area of one of my team channels, and I want to see more information about these files. Right now, all I'm seeing is the name of them, when they were modified, and who modified them. I'd like to see the size of the file and maybe a few other details. So how I would go about doing that, I'm about to show you, and it really is to go into SharePoint and add these columns onto the Teams screen here. Now, by the way, you would have to have enough rights to do this, so provided you have those rights within SharePoint, then you can follow along and do this with me. I'm going to hit the three dots at the top of the files area within Teams here, and I'm going to choose Open in SharePoint. So now you see I'm in SharePoint looking at the same files I was looking at in Teams, and I have a bigger menu within SharePoint that I can work from. And I'm actually just looking at going to the area in the menu called All Documents over on the right side here, and then choosing Edit Current View. So let's do that. And within this Edit Current View, I see all of the columns that I can display by default through SharePoint. Now, note I can make my own columns for other information, and that I'll do in a different video with you, and that's called making your own or working with metadata within SharePoint. So this video is just about how do I bring through normal columns that I would see in Windows Explorer or any other file manager I've been using. So the one I want to bring across is file size. So let's choose that here. And once I do that, I'm just going to go up here to say okay. So when I did that, it took me to the root of my area within this actual team called Estimony Projects. I was in the general channel looking at files, but it's taken me to the main team and all of my channels. So just so you know, this change I've made with file size is affecting all the channels within my team. So I want to go back into general and just show you those files we were looking at. And you see file size is now showing there. Another column that could be handy to have is who created the document, because right now we're seeing modified. So who's modified the document, when it was modified. Maybe you want to know when it was created and who created it. So let's look for these columns next and bring them into our team file area. So I'm going to go to All Documents again and choose Edit Current View. And I'm going to scroll down to where it says created. Oops. So created. So basically who created it and then created by. And if I choose okay at the top. So again, it's taking me to the root of my team, showing me all my folders with this information showing. Let's go into general again. And in those files, the files are showing modified by and created by the same, just because I did upload these files recently. So it's seeing those files as being created recently as opposed to being modified. So if I go and open one of those files now and change it, then it will change that time to be the modified time to be now, right? As opposed to 8 minutes ago. So let's open up one of these files and we'll just make some changes on it. Delete some stuff here. Highlight some stuff. All right, made a couple of minor changes on this file. So I'm glad it's automatically being saved, of course. So I'm going to close out of this file. I'm going to refresh my screen here. And now you see it was created 10 minutes ago, and a few seconds ago it was modified. And if somebody other than me modified it, then of course that information would change as well. All right, so there you have how to add a few basic columns to your SharePoint site. So let's just show you for one last time how these columns show up in Teams. So let's go back to the Teams app so you can see that. So I'm back in Teams. I'm not seeing the change immediately, so it's a good idea just to click on something else so Teams has a chance to catch up and refresh. Okay, let's click on Files of General again and see if the changes are showing now. And they are. So the name of the file shows, the modified, who was modified by, the size of the file, and the created. So whatever changes you make to your columns within SharePoint are going to show through back to Teams. All right, so give that a try. Thanks. Bye-bye.